think she has a good chance. And we're going for the bullet. We're not aiming any lower. Our biggest competition, obviously, will be other boats that are coming in from overseas that are, have similar speeds. But I think we can do it as long as the team is strong and we're ready. I think anything's possible. What I love about sailing is you learn so many life skills, and then you get the social side of it. You get, you have friends that end up becoming your life friends, or you have these trust factors that, that you got my back, I got yours, especially if you're in the middle of a storm. You gotta have somebody you really, really trust. It's just this never-ending learning curve. I grew up initially in a township called Chesterville. I'm trying to explain that to, I guess, family and friends from where I grew up is really difficult. Is, first and foremost, water is perceived to be very dangerous, which it can be. It's not a bad perception, but at the same time, it can teach you a lot of lessons. Growing up with people and explaining sailing to them, it's really difficult. Like some of my family members, it's just impossible to explain. So to them, I'm just a fisherman. I try, you try expose as many people as possible to the sport that are in your group or circle, which I think is really important as well for sailing, is that people need to expose the sport. So I like the racing aspect because it's just always on and there's just always pressure. I like pressure. I've done the Cape to Rio race before and it was one of my, short-term dreams. And I was just like, next Rio race, it has to be in something quicker. I want to go for the win. So I am the skipper of the sport, CFM2, sponsored by Muzzy, and supporting us in terms of being the primary sponsor. People in the sailing community also pulling together and helping. It's been a true blessing.